Chair will entertain a motion.
I move that the State Capitol Arts and Grounds Commission accepts the recommendations of Subcommittee Two and allow the Office of the Secretary of State to proceed with erection of the Ten Commandments monument as proposed by the American Heritage and History Foundation.
We have a second?
I second.
Discussion on the motion. Seeing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, likewise. Ladies and gentlemen, it passes.
Yes.
Now, we need to discuss what will happen next. As set forth in state law, we have to determine, or have determined for us, the cost of the monument. That's the actual creation of this right here, cost of delivery. And then we have to determine the cost of establishing the base and erection of the monument. And those are two separate calculations. By law, those are two separate things. Those calculations and all the money is then supplied to the report supplied to the Secretary of State's office. And our budget office determines what the total cost is. And then we take 10% of each of those two separate numbers and add those together. And then the American Heritage and History Foundation will be supplying the Secretary of State with a check for that amount. That goes into our Monument Preservation Fund, and that's what we use to keep all of these monuments around here in shape. Because it is a permanent monument, there's always ongoing work that goes with it. So I will, this is Sid Rosenbaum, he's the Business Office Director for the Secretary of State. And I'm going to have Mr. Story, I'll just tell you now, if you'll get with Mr. Rosenbaum at the end of this meeting, we'll sit down and start that calculation process to ensure that we get it all right. Y'all will have up to 10 days, if that's suitable with you, to get that number to us. Once we get it, we'll go through the calculations, and then up within 10 days, we will notify you of that amount. You get us a check. Again, I'm just throwing the number 10 days out there because I think we can get it through the mail in that length of time. So what I'm telling you today is we anticipate we could start construction or placement on the grounds around the week of June 10th, what the week has June 10th, June 11th in. That will be weather contingent. The last thing we want to do is get out here in the grass and start digging and get a hole dug and get 3 weeks of rain. Hopefully it's June, we'll hit a dry stretch, probably a week in confident meetings that we've had, we think maybe a week for construction. So hopefully we can, June 10th will be a good number for us. I'm not opposed to coming earlier. You get the numbers, and he gets you the numbers, and you get him the check, and the weather hits a good period. We don't want to be held up with finishing the product, but we want to be flexible because of the weather. Is that okay with you?
That sounds
great. Work with you, Mr. Rosenbaum, the commission. Anybody have a question or a comment about it? Well, congratulations, Mr. Story. I think we have the final, the end game in sight now.
So. I appreciate it. Thank y'all to everyone on the commission.
Now then, I'd like to take just a minute and discuss a couple things that happened in the last legislative session and have happened since we last met as a group. During the session, we had already held a series of meetings on the Ten Commandments. Obviously, you see where we are, on the Satanic Temple, on the Wall of Separation, and on the Gold Star Family Monument. Representative Kim Hammer filed a bill during the session. It was House Bill 1273. And what House Bill 1273 did, once it became Act 274, it included an emergency clause, so it was effective immediately. It stopped consideration by this body of any proposal that is not already sponsored by legislative act. Okay? The proposal by the American Heritage and History Foundation already had an act. That was Act 1231 of 2015. So that stopped.